Hi, I'm Callis. Welcome to this video on how to use the highlighters to go from reading a text to writing a paper. Super helpful in organization, in timing and speed, and making your life a little easier. Now, we're going to do this in the installed version of software. And so the web version works really super similar. The menus are a little different, so if you want to go see that video, you're welcome to, but this one will give you a good idea of both. So let's switch over and see what we have. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit here so you can see. I have just a history book here, and now just for the sake of speed, I'm going to kind of just randomly highlight stuff here. We'll start with the first sentence of the paragraph. And I'm just going to do 3 or 4. Now you notice I'm doing this in yellow. That's because it's the most left color and it makes it the easiest for organization. Next, I'm going to pick green and just do some secondary highlights, my supporting ideas. And then finally, I'm going to go over one more color to blue and do my details. Now these highlights don't make a whole lot of sense. Don't try reading them. But you get the idea. I can do this all throughout my paper from beginning to end, a few times in the middle, whatever I want. Now, what I'm going to do first is show us how to get to an outline. And I do that by coming up here to File and Extract to Column Notes. Extract highlights to Column Notes. You can see I've got my main idea in column 1, my supporting ideas in column 2, and my details in column 3. I click OK. I'm going to just create a new file. So I click OK again. And you can see here I've got my 3 columns of notes. Now, this might be helpful for some people when they write a paper. They may just like this organization method. But a lot of people are more used to the outline format. And so we want to switch to that. And I'm going to repeat my process by going back to File and Extract. And now I have a new option activated, Extract Column Notes to Outline. So there we go. I am now in outline format. I can build on this outline. I can add additional fields. I can type it. I can change it, whatever I want to do. And I'm going to click over here to the right tab because that's going to give me a couple more options. And one of those options is right here in the middle. It allows me to change my document view. If I prefer a graphic organizer, I can change my outline to a graphic organizer. I might need to resize a little there. I can stay in an outline. And when I'm ready to write my paper, I want to still be able to see my outline to help me stay organized. So I click on this third one right here, which is a split screen. My outline stays on the left. And I can start typing on the right. The 1920s were highly affected by World War One.
The 1920s were highly affected by World War One.
Now you hear that, read it back to me after I typed it. That is under my settings, under File. Or tools, sorry, and custom options. I can tell it to read to me when I speak and when I'm typing. Speak is typing. And I can do it by whole character. So if I type really slow, maybe I've got some visual impairment or a little bit of shaking or something, I want to make sure I'm hitting the right letter. I can do whole words or I can do whole sentences. I have it set to whole sentences because I type fast enough that if I do whole words, when I start typing the next word, it cuts it off in the middle. And so you want to adjust that to how you like it. And I'm just going to click cancel because I didn't change anything. Now, I can also use speech to text, which I'm going to actually have in another video. So I'm not going to go over that right now, but you can use speech to text to type as well. And then also a nice thing is I can just click back to the beginning when I've got my paper written, and I can click read and I can go through and proofread the whole thing. So we covered a number of items here, highlighting my document, extracting to column notes using File and Extract, and then extracting again my column notes to the outline. Now, there's another way I can use this that's really helpful. If instead of saying, I want to write a paper with main idea, secondary idea, and details, but rather I'm writing a longer paper and I want to get quotes, I can highlight quotes as well. And I can just highlight them wherever throughout my paper. And then for my second paragraph or my second idea that I'm writing about, I'll go ahead and get quotes for that in the second color. And these can be in any order. I can have them back to back. I can have them all spursed around. Okay, so I've just got a random number of highlights here. Now this time, I'm going to go File, Extract, and I'm going to extract my notes and highlights. And it gives me the master page here. And up at the top, I can arrange annotations by page. I am going to uncheck that. I'm going to click OK. And now it has my annotations, my highlights by color instead of by order. So I can keep this active. I can tile my screen vertically. Well, I've got too many here, so let's close a couple, close it and not save. We'll close this one too. That one. And then we can drag these down. So here, now it's better if I have a big monitor, but I've got my original quotes on the left. I've got my outline in the middle. And I've got my paper on the right. So I can use these highlights to get from my document into my writing quite a few different ways. Find the format that most fits for the project and the level you're working on and make good use of it. Take care.